princess. Chapter 1. Family Trouble. There were once 12 beautiful princesses, all with long flowing hair and short, fiery tempers. Their father, the king, was a grumpy old man who didn't believe in having fun. All of you just sit down and look pretty. In fact, he believed that princess should be seen and not heard. The princess strongly disagreed. The thing they agreed about most was dancing. Her father hated it, but the princess loved it. So whenever he wasn't looking, they dance anyway. Chapter 2, The Sister's Secret. The girls slept in a tall tower with their beds side by side. Every night the king locked the tower door so that they couldn't sneak out. Sleep well, my dears. One morning, when the door was unlocked, the princess was still asleep. As the maid went to wake them, she noted their shoes were leaning in a sockery pills on the floor. The shoes were worn out. How strange! When the king heard about the shoes, he was furious. Those girls had been out dancing. He spoke, "Bring my daughters here now." Yes, sir. Princess should not be out dancing all night. He yelled at them, "You need your beauty sleep. You should all be ashamed of yourself." The girls weren't ashamed in the least. What's more, they wouldn't tell him how they had escaped or where they had been. The next morning, it was clear that the princess had been out again. The same thing happened 7 nights in a row. The king didn't know what to do. Then he had a brilliant idea. He decided that the first man to discover where his daughters went each night could marry one of them. Poster went up across the land. Chapter 3, Taking the Challenge. The first man to take up the king's challenge was brave Prince Marcus. By the way, there is one small catch, the king told him. If you fail, I cut off your head. Okay, no problem, Your Majesty. That night, Prince Marcus was taken to the tower and put in a room next to the princess. Very comfortable indeed. They made him very welcome. One even brought him a cup of hot milky cocoa. As Prince Marcus drank the cocoa, he began to feel sleep. He tired of splashing cold water on his face. But that didn't work. Soon he was fast asleep and snoring loudly. Next morning, the princess's shoes were worn out again. Prince Marcus had failed, and the king wasn't joking about chopping off his head. Take him away! Many more princes and noble knights came forward, but they were all fooled by the princess' sweet smiles and their offer of hot cocoa. Enjoy your drink! Chapter 4. Chapter 4, Ralph and Rascal. One day, a magical named Ralph and his pet dog Rascal were passing the castle. Ralph nods to one of the king's posters and decided to find out more. This could be interesting, Rascal. When he saw Ralph, the king looked doubtful, but he was disappear to know what the girl were off to, so he agreed to let Ralph try. I chop off your head if you fail, you know. Yes, but I won't fail. Night came and Ralph was put in the same room where the others had stayed. Hello, I'm Amy, said the youngest. He's nice, she whispered to her sister. I don't want him to die because of us. Maybe we shouldn't go out tonight. Her sister ignored her. A few minutes later, Annabelle, the eldest sister, brought Ralph a cup of cocoa. But Ralph was always magical. He knew what she was up to. This is for you. I think more than that to fool me. He pretended to drink the cocoa. Then when Annabelle was looking, he poured it into Rascal's bowl. Rascal was delighted. Rap yawned. I think I just pulled my friend off for a few minutes, he told Annabelle. Then, with an even bigger yawn, he pretended to fall fast asleep. Annabelle crept back to her sister. He's asleep, she whispered. Let's get ready. They put on their sparkliest ball dress and new shoes. The princess shimmered like a rainbow. With the last button, buttoned and the last bow tied, the girls stood by their beds. Annabelle put back a dusty old rug in the corner of the room to reveal a secret trap door. The hinges cracked as she pulled it open. One by one, the girls disappeared down some steps and into a long dark tunnel. Chapter 5, Ralph on the Trail. When the princess were out of sight, Ralph quickly entered their room. The clicked his finger and the clock appeared with a second click. Ralph vanished carefully. He tiptoed down the step into the tunnel. It didn't take long for him to catch up with the princess. Ralph tried to work quickly, but it wasn't easy. At one point, it stuck on He stepped on Amy's dress. She jumped and turned around, but there was no one there. A few moments later, Ralph stepped on a twig. Now Amy was convinced that someone was following them. Her sister didn't believe her. What was that? You're just hurting things, silly. At the end of the tunnel, they came to an astonishing row of trees. Some of the trees gleamed with silver, some with gold, and some with sparkling diamonds. Rob has never seen trees like them. While the princess carried on, he gently broke off a twig from each tree. Up ahead, the princess had stopped before the lake. It stood in shadow of a beautiful castle. 12 boats were waiting at the edge of the lake, and in each boat sat a handsome prince. Each prince rode a princess across the lake. Rob snuck into the boat carrying Amy. When they reached the other side, the band began to play. The princess danced until their feet were sore and the soles of their shoes were worn out. As the sun rose, they limped home. Our nights of dancing are still safe, unlike for Russ Pat, said Arabelle, yawning, and Amy looked upset. Chapter 6. A Shock for the King. The king was having breakfast when Rob strolled in. Good morning, your majesty, said Rob brightly. I suppose you've come to tell me you failed too, sighed the king. Ah, but I didn't, sir, Rob replied, waving the twigs. He told the king what he'd seen. This mystery is solved. This all sounds very unlikely, grumbled the king when Ralph had finished. Are you sure you're not just making it up to save your head? He decided to cover Annabelle when she saw the stray twigs in his hand. She looked horrified. One look at her face told the king all he needed to know. Dancing is banned, he declared. The princess sobbed their wails when they heard their secret had been discovered. What will we do? They cried. Life is so dull without dancing. This is the worst day of my life. But there was nothing they could do. True to his word, the king let Rob marry one of his daughters. I'd like Amy, Rob said. If she have me, she's the sweetest of all. I'm sure you both be very happy. Amy and Ralph's wedding were a joyful occasion. Even the kings couldn't stop smiling. I have a surprise for you, he whispered to Amy. The king led her to the ballroom, and Amy guessed hundreds of candles lit up the dance floor, and in the corner A band was playing a lively tune. As it's a special occasion, you may all dance, but for one night only, he said the king. "Oh, how wonderful!" cried Amy and her sister, grabbing partner. They were all still dancing the following night. "I thought I said one night only," said the king, but he smiled. Rob had worked some more of his magic.